how I'm doing the Hyaenadon taming, this method actually does work. It can work with just the basic stuff. I know I'm using the S plus foundation and walls for easy pickup, but you can do this with the basic stuff as well. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you. I've already tamed one of these guys. He's Bud. He's over here. Say hi, Bud. Yeah, new Argent, by the way. We ended up having an ancient Carno tear through pretty much every single dinosaur but a small handful, and that small handful just managed to survive only because of being a dodicarus. Oh, let's see, one's waking up. Alright, so we're gonna want them all to wake up for the most part, because I want the puppies to actually be trying to attack me here, but we need one to attack. Come on. Come on, I know you're scared of me. See, I can't hit you. Let's have a look at you real fast. You're slowly regaining health. They both are. That's the male and female, and then the alpha's a male. Bud's a male. So I was going to name them Bud Lou after, of course, Harley Quinn's puppies. And then I was going to name the other two Bonzi and Shenzi from The Lion King. So as soon as the alpha wakes up, they're going to get aggressive. They're going to want to attack me. Nope. He's wanting to come for me already. Okay. That's fine. I'm wearing the ghillie suit, which is perfectly okay. Because this is what we're going to do. We have him. Ooh, that's the alpha. Did you literally just take over as alpha? I think you're the alpha because the alpha's still asleep over here. Let's have a look, see. Yeah, I think you're the alpha because the alpha over here is asleep. I don't have the spawn keys or anything like that for this server. So, what happened was when my dinosaurs got wiped, I was given like a bunch of stone walls to actually build my trump wall, and then right after that I was given a badass pterodon. I know I'm saying the name wrong. You guys could flame me later in the comments section if you'd like, but I was given a badass pterodon, and then I was told to go to my taming pen. And this is, and I came here and there was like six of these guys in here actually, but my pterodon, being a tolpar affecting badass pterodon, I decided, okay, well, if I'm gonna have to knock them out to tame them, you know, knock them out to tame them one at a time, then I'm gonna do it this way. So I went ahead and would knock them out with the pterodon and accidentally killed a couple of them. And since, are you still alpha? Maybe? I think so, because you're aggressive towards me. Okay, you're about to wake up too, and you're gonna be aggressive towards me as well. So, accidentally killed two of them, so there's four in here still, but they were like all in here, and I'm just like, what do I do? I can't tame them all. They won't let me get near them. They all hate me, right? Because I was wearing my riot gear. I wasn't wearing the ghillie suit like I am right now. See, I'm not naked. I'm actually covering up. And what happened is I was told, yeah, use the ghillie suit and just knock them out and tame them one at a time. Okay, that can work. Go and let me pet you. You gonna run away from me? Okay. That actually would work if I was like able to do that. Knock them out and pet them one at a time. And I was doing that, but I ran into a problem, and that problem was that the one that I kept awake would constantly walk right back to the alpha. The group pack's alpha. And would just get stuck on him and would stay there, and I'm just like, I can't tame him like this. So I've been playing around with some methods here on taming. I think he's still an alpha. Nope. Okay, cool. So alpha status has shifted. We're gonna knock out the female first, because she's gonna be the second or the last one that we're gonna actually... the hell? She's gonna be the second to the last one that we actually want to tame. And so wherever she ends up, it doesn't really matter because she's just gonna run around regardless. She's like really running around though. There we go. Hi, sweetie, go to sleep, please. I should have let them recover their health a little more. Let's see. Okay, she's fine, health-wise. I just need her to pass out. That, she's running. And that's fine if she's running. Because that means she's about to pass out. Now, the one that we do not want near this guy here in this box is the alpha. He needs to go all the way over to that corner over there, which he just ran off to do. So I'm going to shoot him from here. Hopefully he doesn't come charging at me. And he's down. Now, he should still have the alpha glow on him. It is hard to see, but it does look like he has that glow there. So with that in mind, what we do next is we're going to run all the way over here to Button Cappuccino. Just run over this way. And then I crouched and made my way back over to the taming pen. Because now I'm not... showing that I'm aggressive, I'm going to be showing I'm more passive. And there's a bird stuck in my pen for some reason. It's the elusive alpha pelican. So, with the alpha knocked out, and he's in the far corner, and the female over here, which is kind of mate boosting this guy here, I could pet the elf, this dude, and nothing bad will happen. I can even shoot this guy right here. Who just like instantly tranked. But see, now I could like, if I could get into this box, I cannot get into the box. I'm staying crouched down because I don't want to scare him for the most part, but I do want to get into that box and just to hang out with him. To show him that I'm a good person, and it gives me a good view of the other two, mainly the female who was knocked out first, as well as the alpha who will be the last to wake up. And you want the alpha to wake up last, because as soon as the alpha wakes up, the taming bar will start to drop. This is a 5x5 taming pen, by the way. I'm using the stone doorways for pillars as like a guard to allow me to enter and exit if I want to, but they cannot leave and attack me if they really wanted to. I mean, they have to jump over these at one. So if you do something like this and you want to put a little box in, make sure it's a stack of two or more up, due to the fact that they will jump over it and try and get to you. My outer pen is, of course, 3, and I use this for taming other things like saber-tooth cats, wolves, raptors, beavers. Pretty much anything my Argentavis can grab that can actually fit in here without, like, slipping out, I use as a taming pen. I was actually very cautious about using it beforehand with the Hyaenadons as a taming pen because they are a smaller animal, and I was worried that they might actually just be small enough to fit through the door, but I was proven wrong with one of the admins when they gifted me with so many lovely wild level 12 Hyaenadons that will allow me to grow my own Hyaenadon pack of about 20. So I'm actually gonna go ahead and go through the entire taming process with this so you guys can actually see how effective this really is. It is a good idea to keep an eye on the alpha the most, on occasion the female, because while there is a mate boosting going on, it is the alpha who will go ahead and say, no, no more pets for you. You gotta attack these things. You gotta attack these people. And I'm not too worried about the health bar on the, I know you guys can't see me touching it. I'm not too worried about the health bar on the Hyaenadons due to the fact that they regen health quickly. If they, if you're really concerned about them not getting enough to eat, trank something that you can drag into the pen and then leave it there for them to eat so that they can recover their health before going back into doing this method of taming. So let's go ahead and start taming. I'm going to call you Lou. You're going to be Lou. The other dude's going to be Bud. I guess the alpha's going to be Bonzi. And then the female's going to be Shenzi. And if I had a fifth one, it would have been Ed. But I can't win them all, unfortunately. In case you guys are wondering, and if you can't see, this is a 1x1 taming box within a 5x5. It's two up on the two sides inside the pen, and three up along the outer walls of the pen. Pet the puppy. Look at that. He's so happy. So far, this seems to be a very effective method. I might trank that Pelagoras inside the pen if I could get it into the pen. If I had my Pterodon, that wouldn't be a problem. Because of the Annunaki mod, of course, there are going to be badasses. And so, of course, I have a badass Pterodon. With it, I've managed to tame and replenish most of my dinosaur population that I've had, plus some. Like a couple of badass raptors and a badass wolf that I had just gotten. That was an interesting one as I was just flying, charging into it and, you know, spinning so I can, like, use the most effective trinking attack on it without killing it. I had a micro raptor, and I actually had that guy on my shoulder. Unfortunately, a new tribe mate had taken one of my seagulls that I got to try and tame a Hesperian. He took a Hesperian out to the swamp, so I went looking for it in the swamp. And, of course, with all the badasses out in the swamp, there's Ariano broodmothers out there. And there's, like, 10 of them right now. So I'm a little miffed because I lost my microraptor, and if I don't get my seagull back soon, I'm going to lose that as well. I mean, I like my seagulls, kind of. They're annoying overall. They really are. If you attack them, they will steal your shit and they will kill you in the process. So even if you accidentally hit one, it's gonna be like, oh, you hit me, I'm gonna like forever hit you now. They're fucking crows. They are fucking crows. They will stalk you everywhere. And I mean everywhere. I've seen my brother accidentally hit a seagull because it actually dropped right in front of him when he was trinking. I think he was trying to trink a dillo. I can't remember exactly what he was trinking. Dove right in front of him, so it took the trink shot. And because of that, he had to run away from what he was trinking. And he ran all the way to the base, which was like on the other side of the map. And that bird followed him all the way to the other side of the damn map. And, you know, this is a massive map. You guys have seen the tour of the desert, which is, makes up only the southern part of the entire map. And that's east to west. That's not north to south. North to south is very narrow, but east to west is very massive. It is a huge map as of right now. And so you guys seen how long it took me to fly around in the desert carrying a juvenile Moralotops that I lost. So you do know this is a massive map, and when a bird follows you from the west coast to the east coast, it's like the ex-girlfriend that just don't understand that you two are no longer together. You know, it's the crazy ex-girlfriend stalking you from the west coast to the east coast. All right, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. See, I'm already at 58% with Lou, because we got Bud over there. And like I said, I'm using the S plus structures. I better check on the Alpha. I better trink him. And I'm using the darts, not the Anunnaki darts or the Anunnaki arrows, because the Anunnaki stuff I try to use for like much higher leveled item, or not items, but creatures. She's gonna be out for a while still. And the reason why that is because of the fact that I want to be prepared for like sudden spontaneous showings of a dragon popping up and literally eating me in one bite. I want to actually be ready for that kind of stuff. So I'm just using what I have. I'm using the red trank darts, which is the vanilla trank darts, for this, out of the fact that they are low level. The darts themselves are a lot easier to make than the Anunnaki stuff. And they don't do as much damage for like keeping them asleep. As far as taming effects goes, I don't really think this tranking method affects the taming in the end. I mean, every time I've started it, so far that I've started on the taming methods, it's always been at like 100%, and then it drops down over time. So, stone walls for the win. Yeah, this could be a little bit boring, but it's I've had a very interesting time. I think what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna go and tame a badass Onkleo. That's a, I want to say it's 233 or 244 level wise, so you know it's not something you'd find normal level, but that's what we get from playing on a modded server. Anyways, I want to see if I can find the Onkleo and go trank it, tame it, and probably rename it. I don't know yet. I'm really sad because I had a green and dark green Onkleo that I had named Watermelon. And I'm like, oh, this is the perfect name for this Onkleo. I can't wait to stream and show you guys the entirety of my base. And then, homp. All gone. So, yeah, I think this is a better method. Separate and trank. Because, like I said, with the alpha down, you don't have to worry about the alpha, like, barking at the hyenas to get them to attack you. It makes it so much easier to tame. But at the same time, you also gotta make sure that it's just the one. I'm not too certain if having another hyena around would get it to, like, attack or not. Not really willing to find that out myself, to be honest. Just because I've had these guys in my pen long enough to that point that they're getting ready to despawn. And then when I figure out how to actually do an effective taming method for the Hesperians, I'm going to go ahead and show you guys that one as well. But I think this is the most effective method to taming one of these guys, or a whole pack of them. I don't know how this would affect an alpha, to be honest. I don't know if we could still tame an alpha, or if we're going to have to kill another hyena, because that's going to suck. I've already killed two by accident. I don't need to kill a third, and that's like the half of the entire pack right there. Hi, Lou. Yes, you're gonna be Lou soon. We got a couple new Onkleos, though. One is Stone Crusher, and the other one is Bumblebee. Like I said, we have some badass raptors, a badass wolf, of course an Argentavis, a Dodicarus, Quetzal. We actually did tame a Quetzal because I wanted to prove how effective and easy it is to tame a Quetzal now with a badass Pterodon, and like a T-Rex. I'm just literally went flying around in circles. If it was trankable, it would go down. And if it goes down, I would say, do you want to tame it or not? Because I have like the unlimited supply of trank darts with that thing. Let's see, we got like 5 more pets for this guy. And then I'll show you what I did to get Bud at least out of here. Pet. Look at that. Look at that tail wags. Hmm. I yawn way too much. Let's see, 98.3. What do you want to bet the next pet is going to be a 99.9? I have a feeling it's going to be a 99.9. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pet. Okay. Bud and Lou. Who's Harley Quinn's favorite comedian? Oops, I forgot. I'm still crouching. There we go. I don't think I actually got that. I'm hoping I got that. I knew I didn't get that. That's okay, because we got extras. We'll pick this up. And then we'll take this down and this down. Come on, Lou. I'm just going to keep that at too high for right now. We're going to bring Lou all the way over here next to Bud, who is now an alpha. Because he is actually higher level than Lou. I'm going to go ahead and have you unfollow. And apparently you have some more levels. Wow. These are low levels, I will admit. Normally they will not be worth it, but I don't care at this point. The point is to actually tame the stupid things. Because I've seen a lot of people have, like, these extravagant taming pens just for these guys. Alright, so she's going to wake up soon. And he's still out of it for a bit longer. I might actually be able to encourage her to come attack me over here. And if I do, she's going to jump out. Well, she's not going to jump out. She's going to try jumping at me. But she's not the alpha. He is. And I at least want to tame her second to last. Out of the fact that she is the surviving female. You need some food, don't you? Come on, Cappuccino, give me. Thank you. We're gonna put that into melee damage. And you're gonna eat up. You both are gonna eat up. I'm gonna find a bird for you two to, like, just eat up. Ah, here's one. Alright, Bud Lou. These would make some great warg designs, actually. For, like, fantasy-based stuff. Anyways. Here, easy food. Attack it. Are you guys seriously shy of the river? You guys are seeing this, right? I'm telling them to attack the bird there. And they're both refusing to move. Alright, so you guys don't want to fight for food. Okay. Let's go put you back by the burb. Okay, so she should be waking up soon. If I'm lucky, I might actually be able to push her. Yeah, she's gonna wake up soon. I'm gonna see if I could push her this way. I'm not gonna knock him out again because I don't need him to die. Kinda worked. Let's see if I could get her to get into that area. Go on, Missy. Run away, run away. Awesome. So I want to do that, and that, and that, and now she's boxed in there, so she cannot escape per se, but she still has her health to regen, so I'm gonna let her be for now. I won't be able to pet her until she's fully healed, and then I also do not want him to die, so I'm gonna, like, back off for now. Let them both heal. And of course, Cappuccino's got a level. I don't know, maybe I'll have these guys for like a cleanup crew with my hunting pack. I normally like to hunt with LSRs, to be honest. Like, they're aggressive, they're bossy, they don't take shit from no one type of deal. And I love hunting with them. I used to, on my own server, I had like a pack of 15. And I absolutely loved them. And then they got destroyed by a Giganotosaurus. That was like a level 5 Giga, destroying a level 200 plus LSRs. So when she wakes up, or she's already awake, she should be calm enough. Apparently she's not calm enough to let me pet her. That's fine. We're gonna wait for the alpha to wake up and fully heal. Because he's gonna need that. I guess I could check up on Bud and Lou and see how they're doing food-wise. Why are you not eating? Apparently, I don't do much damage to her face. Alright, how are you looking? You're almost waking up. That's a good thing, though. 'Cause as soon as you wake up, I'm gonna, like... hang out over here. Or something. The elusive white Pelagoras. And I missed. Yeah, I'm not even hitting it at all. But I would like for it to land, at least land over here. See, now he's awake, she's awake. We're gonna check him out first. See, he's still recovering his health. I'm hoping he's able to recover his health. Yeah, he's regaining his health right now. As soon as that's maxed out, I'm going to try doing the same thing, pushing him back into that far corner. So that way he can be away from her as I tame her. Oh, that would have been so much better with my pterodon. Let's see how much health he has. Okay, so he's fully recovered. And as soon as I start shooting him, he's going to want to attack me. See? We're going to want to push him back to the other corner. It looks like he's kind of scared of me. Keep running, buddy. Let's see if I can get him to run around. In that corner. Go on. Okay, so we have him over here. We want him down in that corner over there. Keeps running to the wrong corner. If you notice, she's going to try and attack me. But he will not. Come on, bud. Just get in that corner. He hates that corner. See, if he's over here, he's too close, and I won't be able to tame her. And that would make the whole taming point moot. Let's Let's have a look at your topar. Let's see if that worked. Okay, perfect. So he's in that corner. And he's down. And I'm hungry. I guess running around trying to get him to get in the corner takes a lot out of you. So come over here just to make sure. Crouch down, and then we kind of skimmy back over to here. To her. And then we do the same thing that we did with Lou. Just the whole petting in the box until she's tamed. Hopefully at this point, that one will no longer be an alpha and I'll be able to tame him. Can I pet you? Yes, I can. Hi, sweetie. Just kind of chill in the corner with the Hyaenadon. This might seem like it takes a lot of work, which it kind of does, but once you have your pen set up in a particular way, it tends to work for you. This is only one method I came across in trying to tame these guys. Fuck, I didn't go into the pen. Out of the fact that, like I said, I saw like some very elaborate and resource expensive taming pens that would not be possible to do in general. This is a very simple pen. I use it for taming everything else. Like I said, anything that I could carry with an Argent that cannot fit through these doors gets tamed in here. So it's very simple. Nothing over the top. It's just a simple 5x5 square with a 1x1 in a corner, and then you just kind of like put the alpha off to the side in the far corner. And you don't have to chase the Hyaenadon all over the place. You don't have to build up like these separate taming pens. You can put as many Hyaenadons as you want into a taming pen, find out who makes themselves the alpha, and then see how many of these guys you can tame before they start to despawn. We'll tame Shanzi, and then I'm going to see if I can tame the last guy, who would be the alpha. Because he should no longer be an alpha at that point. Actually, I'm going to check up on something real fast. Pet you. Whoops. Pet. Since he's off in this corner. Put that there. Okay, so what I'm gonna try and do is pet her. I lost my wrist guard. Okay, so I'm trying to start the taming pen for him, let him regen his health, and then I was gonna see if I could like just start petting him instead of trying to corner him into his own. To the same corner with everybody else. so. Like, if you don't like the way that I do this, that's, you can come up with your own method on taming these guys. This is just a method I find to be resource friendly, because all you really need is stone, thatch, and wood. Something that I could actually find on this tiny island is nothing but stone, thatch, and wood. On the Ragnarok map over by the lagoon. And it's just easy for me because it's a flat piece of land. Not a lot of dinos spawn in, and now not, it's a whole lot less. I mean, I have my tiny little thatch hut here, but that's a different story. Goodness, I'm so tired. They kind of look like a weasel, not just a dog, but like a weasel. Definitely a hyena. A very, very limp tail, so their tails might be broken. Of course, as I said that, she wags her tail. I really want a shoulder buddy. I think I want to find another micro raptor. I mean, I could go to the desert and just like barrel dive through everything and trick one that way, but I have to take a rare flower with me at the very least. Did you fall out of the window again? My cat, the grace of a ice skater skidding across some melting butter. I'm gonna pet this guy. Even if the alpha was to awaken, I don't think he's gonna be alerted right away. You're gonna box me in here, aren't you? I'm gonna drink you just to make sure. There. It's getting dark. Something else I've done with this is I've set up torches. Looks like one got destroyed actually. So I'm gonna have to figure out what destroyed that one torch, because there was a torch on each side so that no area was too dark. Hopefully it's not too dark for you guys to not to be able to see. Gotta go through this one more time. A little over halfway done. So I definitely want to see if I could tame that alpha. Pretty certain I can, but I want to make sure. when I tame this one, I'm gonna tame the alpha just to see if I can actually do it. If I can't, then I don't know what I'm gonna do with him. She's definitely gonna be not able to actually run around with the boys and level up with them until she actually has a couple of pups. Like 10. If I'm using a Hyaenadon pack, I'm gonna make sure it is a frigging pack. Like a painted dog pack. Which is usually a size of 20. Two to three more pets. Come on, Shinzi. Shinzi. Good girl. Come on. Let's get you situated with the others. And get you some food. Because you gotta be starving. Yep, see, you're hungry. There you go. Now to fix up my actual taming pen on that one side. Excuse me. Set these up like that. And now to watch him. Well, I guess I got some time. So what I could do is I could take these guys back. All right, you three, come on. following you three this way. Dino gate's over here. Okay, I can kind of see them, so that means that you guys can't even see them. But they're following me. Trust me. Go. Ooh, red drop. But I'm getting a ton of alpha saddles with those, so I try to avoid them. Alright, so it will be... I saw a car now, I don't want it to follow me through here. Okay. Cappuccino. Let's have a look at this guy here. He still looks like he's out of it. So now I gotta play the waiting game. Wait for the pup to wake up. I wouldn't know what else to say at this point outside of the fact of just let me know if this taming method works for you or if you found something else that works out better. When it comes to the Hyaenadons, as I said, I'm trying to work out all the kinks and stuff on this taming stuff, and I know I'm not the only one because there's other people who are trying to do the same thing. These are annoying tames. Well, this one's a little bit more easier. Excuse me. This one's a little bit more easier than the Hesperian, because the Hesperian is like, you have to drag the fish to them and then feed them the fish that you're dragging, and they will take forever to feed. So you have to constantly keep dragging fish to them, which means you have to be fishing or you have to use the seagull to catch your fish. Sun's coming up. Let's have a look at this pup. Yay! He's almost ready. Almost. By the way, that red drop is up over there somewhere. As soon as he wakes up, he's going to start recovering his health, which is what we want. And then we're going to see about approaching him to pet him. If we can pet him, that's awesome. If we cannot pet him, then oh shit. La 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 la. I have my hair back in a ponytail, so I'm messing with it. Except for it keeps getting caught. My finger does. Almost awake! Yee! 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Awkwardly slow wake up call. Now we gotta wait for the health to regen. And as long as he doesn't see us, we're good. So when they're weak, they will not attack, but when they are strong, you know, fully healed, they feel invincible. Alright. He's fully healed. Let's see if we can, like, come up and pet him. You gonna run away from me? You don't look like you're running. Looks like you're just walking around. Can I pet you? Yes, I can. I can pet the alpha! Or he's the ex-alpha now, because Bud took over. Hey, Bonzi! Shenzi says she no longer likes your pelt. Are you running away from me? I think he's running away from me. Yeah, I think he's a little intimidated by me, so we are going to go over here and reset this all over. One too many tranks to the head, you know? Kinda does that to a guy. Okay, so that should reset that. I guess I wasn't far away enough. Let's see if this does it. It's not letting me pet him.
I'm gonna try something else. Cappuccino, come with me. Yeah. You always need a level up. Where do we put the poochies? There they are. Okay, I'm grabbing Bud. Crap, that Carno's still there. Alright, so I'm gonna put Bud back. I'm gonna grab Knockout. By the way, I need a better name for my Quetzal. Come on. If you guys could think of a better name than Pretzel, please, please, please tell me. This is how I knock out dinos now. And you know what? That's the second time you came around to do this. 74, you're not even worth it. I'm gonna see if this actually helps. Resolve my alpha dog Hyaenadon issue here. Now I'm crouching. Because I pet him. And he started running away from me. And now he won't let me pet him. Yeah, I don't think he trusts me. See, I can't pet him. I'm for some reason adding stone into my inventory when I'm not even looking at stone, because that's logic. Maybe that's it. Or maybe I should start using bug repellent. Yeah, he won't let me touch the booty. So I'm gonna try one other thing. And if it don't work, then I don't know what to do with the alpha, unfortunately. Top arrow and griffins are the only ones that can fly backwards. Everyone else cannot. See, I need citronel. I'll take all. Pull. What else do I need? Pelt, hair, or wool, and rock carrots. Wait a minute, is that badass? $2.99 female badass scorpion. I'm gonna have to knock that shit out. I'm gonna have to go tame her. So, I should leave the bug spray on you. Awesome. So for I need to go grab. Do you have them? No, you don't. The smithy has them. There you are. Thank you. And rotten meats. Come on. Come on. Achoo. I gotta go get my other stuff. I'm supposed to be taming a alpha hyaenadon, not a badass scorpion. But hey, rare opportunities come in all packages and sizes, right? Now, why did you stop eating? One more bite? Nope. Okay, let's get you into base. If somebody can tell me what the fire symbol is supposed to actually do, because it doesn't do anything. It doesn't burn or anything like that. Okay. You stay there. You hold this. And I guess this, and this, and this, and this, and this. But that's it. If I cannot tame this Hyaenadon, I really would hate to put him down. Let's see if this actually would help calm the Hyaenadon down about me petting him. Nope. He is absolutely terrified of me. As you can see, he is absolutely terrified of me if I try to pet him. Calms down a lot faster. So he's full on health, full on everything else. I don't know where he gets the food from. Empty topar. But I cannot pet him. He won't let me. I really didn't want to do this, but I'm gonna have to. Oops. I got lucky on that one. Alright, so you've seen me try taming the alpha. I just can't tame him. I don't know if it's because I trinked him one too many times, if it's because of the fact that they do need an alpha nearby them to be tamed. A wild alpha, not a tamed alpha. If it's because of the fact that he was just all by himself, or you know, he got sick and tired of being, of having all his friends taken away from him. I mean, there's a good number of scenarios as to why I could not tame the alpha. But we have Budloo and Shenzi. I think that's a great trio right there of puppies. Even though Bud's like facing away from us right now. Of course, you need a level up. You always need a level up. Come on. And I think I'm gonna have them follow Beast. Only because it would make sense that they would follow Beast, and then, of course, the raptor gets the, well, raptors. There. And look at that. Beast is one hell of a beast of a badass wolf. Alrighty, this has been Tiki Bomber. Thank you for this early morning stream. Hopefully you guys come up with better methods or can actually answer my question about taming an alpha hyaenadon.